Hello and welcome to the Anxious Knitter Podcast. My name is Joy, and I am the Anxious Knitter. I'm so anxious that I can't watch movies about infectious diseases because I'm kind of a hypochondriac and I will immediately think that I'm dying. But I'm only a little bit sick today, no infectious diseases to be found, and we are back for episode 9. Like I said, my name is Joy and I'm coming to you from Waterloo, Ontario, Canada, where I live with my husband Luke and our dog Opie, who I'm really sorry if you can hear him licking my hands. I just put coconut oil on, so he really likes that. This is a podcast mostly about knitting, but occasionally about crochet, sewing, and whatever crafty thing catches my fancy at the moment. If you are a returning viewer, thank you so much for coming back. It means a lot to me that you would want to spend a little bit of your day with me. And if you are brand new, just stumbling on my little corner of the internet for the first time, welcome! And I hope you find something that you like or that you find interesting. So yeah, I hope you guys have all had a wonderful week so far. I decided to change up my background. I was getting a little bored with that beige wall. I don't know that this is like that much better. I'm in my office right now, which is really just a dumping ground. I don't know if you can tell by my like bookshelf sitch happening behind me. Looks pretty bad actually. Oh well. If only you knew the amount of rigging it took for me to get in here today. But anyway, yeah, I have a few things to talk about today. Sorry, it's so distracting having him here. He's being so cute right now. I'll see how long he stays. I hope he stays for the whole thing. Yeah, so I hope you guys are doing well and you've been having a good time knitting and working on projects that are making you happy. And yeah, I guess, okay. So as always, my first segment is Dweeb Story of the Week. And at first I was like, oh, I don't think I have one, but I think I do. It's a joint dweeb story for me and Luke. I'm going to be talking about this experience sort of throughout the episode today, but Luke had a day off that he had to take before April 1st, so we took that day on Monday and we had a day trip. And one of the things we were doing was going to a yarn store in Hamilton, Ontario, which is a little ways away from where we are, somewhere we've been to Hamilton, but we've never been to this yarn store. So we knew it was downtown, so we had the GPS, and we were driving along, and we found it, and we're like, yes, and then we're like, let's find parking, it's a Monday afternoon, shouldn't be hard. Then we realized that all of the downtown parking in Hamilton is metered. Which you would think, I feel like most people are going, yeah, Joy, obviously, downtown parking tends to be metered in general. But all of the downtowns that we frequent are not metered. So, like, Kitchener's downtown, Waterloo's uptown, Guelph's downtown, they're not metered parking. So we didn't even think to have cash on us. And so then we had to use my data. I don't have a lot of data on my phone, okay, because, like, phone plans in Canada are, well, I don't know if it's true in all of Canada, but phone plans in Ontario are the worst. And, yeah, so we had to find a Shoppers Drug Mart so we could get cash back. And it was so stupid. And you know what was especially stupid is we had to get $20 of cash back because that was the minimum amount. Please stop licking because I feel like that sounds really gross for everybody. Nobody wants to hear you slurping away, okay? Jeez, dogs, am I right? But we needed like $1 worth of change for parking because like we were gonna be downtown for like less than an hour. So we had to buy a chocolate bar and get $20 of cash back so that we could use actually 50 cents because we were only at the yarn store for half an hour. Anyway, it was so dumb that we had to actually like, and then Luke is like, I should keep $5 of change in my wallet at all times for moments like this. And I was like, that's a good idea. And then he spent all of the change on that $20 of cash back. So we're still back at square one with no change for emergency meter parking. So, yeah. I hope you enjoyed that story of us being total dweebs and unprepared. I swear we'd do better when we actually travel. It's just like when we're traveling sort of semi-locally that we suck at it, apparently. Yeah, so that sort of segues nicely into knitting, doesn't it? So why don't we start with my first official knitting segment? That was sort of awkward. Whatever. Finished objects! Woo! Okay. I only have a half finished object, which I'm guessing you can guess what kind of half object that is. It's a sock. Spoilers! Yes, I finished the first of my Weasley Homestead socks, which is a pattern by Erica Luter. It's free on Ravelry. Harry Potter related, obviously. Yeah, I'm pretty pleased with it. Oh, he's leaving. Oh, are you okay, buddy? It's a bit of a jump. I'm sort of propped up on, like, cushions from our balcony set, and it's making this chair pretty high up. Off he goes. Anyway, socks. Yes, so I finished the first one pretty smoothly. Everything went pretty well. The only thing, obviously, was that I didn't do that, like, an extra row, there we go, an extra row around of just plain stockinette in the blue to smooth out that join, so that kind of annoys me, but otherwise, I really like it. It's sort of hard to see the pattern, but it's like a alternating 2x2 rib kind of thing going on. I did 15 rows of 2x2 ribbing in green, and then I did an extra so I knit my foot now to 70 rounds, and I did 60 of the blue, and then I did an extra 10 of the green because I like the way it looked. I liked having more of the toe. And a viewer kindly reminded me of the inside number 23's Harry Potter long, year-long Harry Potter long. I don't know how I forgot about it, seeing as, like, I have actually entered something into it, I think in February or January. So thank you for that reminder. So I will be entering these once I finish the second one. Fish Lips Kiss Heel. The yarn is scraps I had from two past projects, both hats. So this, the green variegated is Lichen and Lace in her 80-20 sock in the seagrass colorway. And then the blue is Madeline Tosh Twist Light in the ink colorway. And I really like both of them. Yeah, and I actually really like that I'm able to get like two projects out of both these skeins of yarns. And actually probably three, because I think I'm going to have enough left over to do heels, cuffs, and toes in the green for another pair at some point. Okay. Yes, so first one finished, and I'm getting pretty close to being done. Oh, I had already opened it. I prepared. Thanks, past me. So I've done the leg, I've put in the heel, and I've started the foot. So that will definitely be done by the next podcast, so you'll be able to see the full pair. Of course, I can't just do a thing properly, like learn from my mistakes or whatever, but so I remembered to do the cuff join properly, so that's nice and neat and pretty. But then I went to go put in the heel, and I realized I hadn't done that extra, well, it's not extra, but you do the, like, inch or so of stockinette for the Fish Lips Kiss Heel before the heel, and I just did the patterning all the way through. So hopefully that doesn't affect the fit too much. I don't think it will, and honestly, who's gonna notice? And it's really dark yarn, so I'm hoping it's fine. Knitting them on my high highs, these are just the regulars on a 40-inch cable, which is really annoying me right now. And 2.25 millimeter. Don't know if I just said that, but anyway, let me just pop that back in the bag. Yeah, so that's all I have for finished objects. I kind of thought that I would have my shawl done, but I didn't. I ended up starting a new cast on. Whoops. Sorry, not sorry. So why don't we just shift right along to works in progress. All right. Got a couple today. Just a couple. You will not be seeing my cup of tea mitts today because I didn't work on them at all. Whoops. I feel like that's kind of saying something, that I'm not working on them. And, like, it's annoying because I really want the finished product, but, like, knitting them is kind of annoying me right now. So I haven't worked on them. I'm taking a break. So I started something new instead of working on them, which is a pair of socks. Surprise! I'm obsessed with socks right now. I feel like the moment is going to come when I'm gonna get maybe a little bit bored of them. Like, not bored, but just, like, socked out. Like, I'm just gonna need a break from socks. But that day is not today. So I cast on a pair of stripey socks. Oh my gosh, look at this cable. Isn't that brutal? It's annoying me. Everything's annoying me. I'm really sorry. I'm, like, bitter today or something. I'm not living up to my name is what's happening. Yes, so I cast on one of my Knit Picks Felici in the toucan colorway. So here's what I have. They're small. Yes, so I have done the cuff. I finished the leg. I think I might do an extra stripe. But I'm also thinking it ended pretty, like, concretely on that stripe at the 60 row, so maybe I will just pop in the heel today. And then I can get going on the foot and hopefully have at least a hoe for you next week. But I'm really, really, really enjoying this. This yarn is so soft. If you haven't worked with it yet, I would recommend it. It is kind of pilly. You can see, like, it is a little pilly, but, like, what do you expect when you pay, like, $4 for a ball, right? Like, can you really complain? Also, they're just really cute. And these colors, speak joy, speak properly, precision of language. These colors kind of remind me of Luna Lovegood, so I'm gonna make these Harry Potter socks too. I'm having a Harry Potter moment. Like, it's funny because I think of Harry Potter mostly as a fall thing. Like, it's something I read in the autumn and I watch the movies in the autumn. But, like, right now I'm just having a Harry Potter thing. Like, I just want to read the books. I just want to knit everything Harry Potter related. I don't know what that's about. Is anyone else having this, like, resurgence of Harry Potter mojo obsession at the beginning of spring? Is that weird? I don't know. But that is being housed in my squashy Adventure Time bag that Luke made me, his very first bag. Oh, it's an Adventure Time bag beard. It looks terrible. Yeah, but I'm really liking this. I was knitting on this when we were driving to Hamilton. It was a nice project. And I just think that Knit Picks Felici is definitely worth... It lives up to the hype, I think. And I think it's definitely worth the price tag. Yeah, so my only other work in progress is, and I bet you guessed it, my Pure Joy shawl, which is a pattern by the legendary Hohe Locatelli. And I feel like it looks like maybe I said this last time too, it looks like I didn't make a lot of progress, but I feel like I actually did a lot of knitting on it. So I'm on wedge 4, right? Let me just count real quick. Yes, wedge 4, not including the little starting knot wedge. But I'm still loving it. I'm still obsessed with these colors. I can't wait to have this for spring and summer. It just looks like, doesn't it look like a magical seashell or something? And you really can't tell because, I mean, the MacBook camera is good, but it's not wonderful. But this yarn has such a lovely sheen and just glows, and, like, it just looks so lovely in person. And yeah, I'm really excited to get this off the needles and blocked out, and I'm excited to wear it all the time. Especially because, I don't know if you've noticed, but I wear a lot of black. Black and navy, but really a lot of black. And this is just going to look, doesn't this already just look nice just with a black shirt? Gosh, you can't lose with these kind of colors. And the yarn is, as I'm sure you're tired of hearing me say, Indigo Dragonfly, the variegated, the multicolor variegated is the, oh, I think I have the, hold on. I'm sorry if this makes noise. Okay, here. I've just been calling it the Blade Runner colorway because I couldn't remember, but it's called the Double Deckered Blade Runner colorway. And it is 50% superwash merino, 50% silk. It's gorgeous. And the yellow I'm using for the eyelets, which it's hard to see right now, but when I get to the sixth wedge, you will be able to see that color in all its glory. It's just the, it's a, her, like a merino nylon sock in the Delectable Yellow Dalek colorway. So I really, really flippin' love this. I was just showing you the wrong side, my bad. But yeah, it's getting pretty big. I'm getting a little paranoid about it falling off the needles when I'm putting it away, because it still doesn't have a bag, because Luke, okay. I'm joking, obviously, I don't care. But like, we have had pieces cut out for a shawl-sized bag for like a bajillion years now, and I would like to be able to put my shawl in the shawl bag for posterity before I finish the shawl. Got me? All right. Yeah. Oh, and if you just wanted to see the my Easter egg ball of yarn and the yellow cake, which is scrumptious. I do love this color so much. Yeah. So that's kind of it for what I've been working on. I need to work on saying, don't I? I guess. Anyway, so that brings me to my next segment, which is my last knitting-related segment, which is stuff I bought for knitting. And actually, I have to go and get something that I forgot in the living room, so be right back. And with the magic of editing, I have returned a split second later. It's a miracle. Yes, so I have some really exciting things to show you today. At least I think they're exciting, and I hope you find them at least, like, mildly interesting. But I've actually acquired quite a bit of yarn. And the first one I'm going to show you... Hold on, can I do it without, like, spoilers? Okay. So... I'm going to tell you a little story about this yarn. So I follow, like most people, the Legacy Knits podcast, Sue and Chelsea. And I saw... Okay, first of all, like, let me just say that I am, like, desperate for the Winnie Sanderson yarn. And I'm, like, I'm waiting for them to dye it up again. But in the meantime, they have come out with a range of colors based on Bates Motel, which is a TV show. Now, I have not seen Psycho. I know. I'm gonna watch it, though. I had seen some of Bates Motel, but I knew that my parents love Bates Motel. So I had told my mom and sent her, like, all the pictures of the colorways, and my mom was like, oh, like, that would be really, really cool to, like, have socks or something knit out of this. I was like, yes. I was like, but it's going to be really hard to get because obviously they sell it really quickly because they dye up really awesome colors. So this was the first time, okay, so then my mom and I decided we were going to try for one of their updates. And so this is the first time I've ever done one of those things where, like, you're sitting there, like, waiting, like, with the refresh button going, like, on Etsy or whatever to try and buy yarn. And we got it. We had a system, so we were both going for it. I was going for our second choice colorway in case my mom couldn't get the first choice colorway. So at least then we would still get one of the colorways. But we did get our first choice colorway. So my mom ordered two skeins One of them is for me, and one of them is for her. Well, I'm gonna be making socks for my dad. But yes, here they are. Oh my word, look at them. Aren't they great? So this is the Mother's Home colorway, which is based on like the creepy house that the Bates family lives in. So if you don't know what Bates Motel is, it's like sort of a prequel-ish series about Norman Bates, who is the villain in Psycho. And it's a really, really good show. I actually like started watching it after, when we were thinking about buying the yarn, because I'm like that. I'm like, if I'm going to be knitting with Bates Motel yarn, I better have context. So I'm on season 2 now. I'm really, really enjoying it because I love horror, as you know. So yeah, I love it. It's so like dark and moody, and I think it's gonna look so good. I think I'm gonna do for my dad a pair of plain vanilla socks, and then for me, I'm gonna do Hermione's everyday socks, because I think the texture is gonna look really nice with the variegation. And we got it on the Cozy Toes base, which is 80% merino, 10% cashmere, 10% nylon. Yeah, 435 yards for 100 grams. Legacy Fiber Arts. So you should definitely check them out. They're doing a Game of Thrones yarn club, which I would love to do, but not really in the cards for me right now. But maybe they'll do another one. Either way, the second they are dyeing up their Hocus Pocus yarns again, I'm going for it. Like, I don't even care how much it costs. I'm getting a Winnie Sanderson yarn. But yes, here's close up so you can see. I absolutely love it. I was so excited. Like, I felt like such an idiot because, like, I, like, screamed. Like, my mom and I were, like, on the phone, like, okay, go, 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 go. And, like, panicking and it was actually really fun. Like, it's kind of, oh, wow. Sorry, guys. Full on pink on my teeth. That's embarrassing, though. Anyway, it was really exciting. It's kind of an adrenaline rush. Does anyone else get that? Is that why you do it? Like, when you're trying to get, like, woolen fine yarns and stuff? Like, is it just for the adrenaline? Because it was a lot of fun. So, I'm really excited to knit with this. And I love Sue and Chelsea, and their packaging was really nice. They sent a really pretty, like, Hedy Lamarr postcard and a little candy, and it was so sweet. And I will definitely be ordering from them again. So, very excited to cast those on. I think I'm going to save my socks for a little bit, but I am going to cast my dad's socks on pretty soon. And then the second thing that I got was from that yarn store in Hamilton. So I have the card right here, which, because it's really, really nice. It's called Hand Knit Yarn Studio. Ooh, look at that. Wow, what is happening to my light, though? Okay, I'm sorry. I just got real blue cast just now. Does that do anything? No. Okay, anyway, so this store is so cute. It looks so, like, tiny from the outside, but it's pretty, like, deep. And I was really happy to see that they had a lot of things that my local yarn store, Shelby Knit, does not carry. So certain brands of needles, certain brands of yarn, or, like, even if they have the same brand of yarn, they were carrying different colorways. So it was nice to, like, go into the store that's, you know, still fairly close, less than an hour away, if you don't hit too much traffic, and still was able to come out with things that were totally brand new to me. So the first thing that I got was a pair of, oh, whatever, I'll leave that on, of Chowgu sock needles. 32-inch cable, size 1, so 2.25 millimeter. I don't know. But what I really liked was when I pulled this out, you can already see that the cable is not curled in. Like, you know how, like, sometimes you, I find this with my hi-hi's, is that you pull it out and, like, it just wants to stay in that, like, curl that it's in, and then you have to heat it up. Like, I don't even think I have to put this in hot water. Like, it's just, it's really nice. The cable is thicker, I think. It feels thicker, but I don't know how much, if that's going to change anything. But I'm really excited to find out, because now at least I know that they're somewhere fairly close. Like, it's like 10 or 15 minutes away from IKEA, and Luke and I go to IKEA like 6 times a year, at least. So it's not hard to like pop in, just grab a set of needles if I need them. So I'm very interested to see how I like them, but I'm pretty optimistic. Let me know if you are a Chow Goo fan, and like if you've used both Hiya Hiyas and Chow Goos, how you feel about them. Okay, I can't get this back in right now. So let's just put that over here. And like which one you prefer and why, because I'm very interested. I like to try out lots of different things. There's one thing that I have to say almost across the board is like invest in your tools, because they're gonna make your life easier. Although, I mean, even I have to sometimes take that back, because I've been using the same set of brushes, like watercolor brushes, since I was literally 14 years old. And they were not expensive brushes. They're like entry line brushes, but they're the best brushes I've ever used. But whatever. But of course, I didn't just go to a yarn store and buy needles, especially because I don't know when I'm going back. So of course I bought yarn. And I'm very excited about both these colorways. The first one I'm going to show you, it was like I saw it and I knew that I needed it in my life. Sorry, I'm just trying to tuck in some of the ends. But the first skein I got is this, and it's like, it's blowing out a little bit, but, that's okay, yeah. It's coming in out a little darker than it is. It's a really lovely robin's egg blue, and can I tell you, I have been on the hunt for a robin's egg blue yarn that is, like, properly robin's egg blue, and this is the closest I've seen so far. But you can see, like, it's really nice and tonal. It's got lovely brown and rusty and blue speckles. It is Julie Aslin. And it is, I think it's just called Speckle 2. It's not got a special name. Lazu Fingering, 90% superwash merino, and I think it's 10% silk. It's in French, so I cannot translate all of it. I'm guessing it's silk, but whatever. Proudly spun for us in Canada, so that's kind of cool. This yarn store really focuses on things that are like sustainable, eco-friendly, that kind of thing. So they have a lot of options like that. But yeah, so I saw this and I kind of like knew like I had to have this. I wanted to specifically buy a yarn for a shawl, because once I finish my Pure Joy, I don't actually have any more shawl yarn. All the yarn I have is specifically for socks. Now, I'm going to an event in April, which I will talk more about in April, where I am obviously going to be buying more like yarn, like shawl specific yarn, but it's still for not another month, and I'll probably be done the Pure Joy in the next week or so. So I wanted something that would go for shawl. So once I picked this, it was about picking a skein to go with it, and the one that I ended up picking was this. What did I tell you? Spring, and I'm going into the pastels. I've moved away from the moody colors. Oh, isn't it pretty? It's Manos del Uruguay Alegria, which means joy in Spanish, which is kind of cool. And the colorway is Kaibo? I don't know. It's Ceibo. 75% superwash merino, 25% polyamide, 445 yards. So really nice yardage. But I was going back and forth between this one and another one that was like white with like a lot of pink and purpley speckles, but then I thought, I just kept coming back to this skein, and I was like, oh, I love that. But like, look how pretty this is. together. Oh, we'll just make a lovely spring shawl. I wish I was going to have it done for Easter, but I don't think I will even have started it by then. Not 100% sure on what pattern I'm doing. I'm kind of going back and forth. I really want to knit, as I've mentioned before, the Sizzle Pop shawl by Leslie Ann Robinson, and I will knit it. But I'm worried that even though these are different colors, you know, pink base, blue base, they're not too different tonally. So I don't know that the leaf motif is gonna pop enough, like as much as I want it to. And so I'm also thinking about, I think it's called the Love of a Spider. I'll put the title down here, obviously. By Melanie Berg, which is a really pretty slip stitch colorwork shawl. And I'm kind of leaning towards that one because it will be a lot more subtle than the one in the picture. And I will put in a picture here. And I like that it's like a big triangle. I'm kind of feeling a triangle shawl right now just because I've knit two crescent shaped shawls in a row. And so I'm like, I kind of want to try something a little different. I'll just shake things up a bit. And I really like the way that one looks. And it's inspired by Charlotte's Web, which is one of my favorite childhood books. And I was in the play Charlotte's Web recently. So I thought that would be nice. But yeah, let me know what you think. Let me know if you have any, like, recommendations for a two-color shawl that you've really loved or that you've been eyeing and you think would look pretty in these two yarns. But yeah, they were really, really nice at this yarn store. So if you are an Ontarian, whatever, I don't know what it's called, and you haven't been to Hand Knit Yarn Studio in Hamilton, Ontario, you should definitely give it a look-see. It's really, really nice. Yeah, that's it. That's all I've bought for knitting. So that essentially brings us to the end of the knitting part of the podcast. So if that's all you came for, I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you again next week, hopefully. And I keep forgetting to mention this, but if you ever have any questions about my knitting, about crochet, about me, whatever, feel free to leave those in the comments and I can answer those on the podcast for you if there's just anything pressing that you'd like to know. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed that part of the podcast, but if you would like to stick around, I have a couple things to talk about in my life, etc. So the first thing I wanted to just quickly mention was a podcast that I discovered recently that I love. I only watched one episode, but I'm gonna definitely be like going back to the beginning and watching them all. And that is the Tea and Possibilities podcast hosted by Nikki. She is so lovely. I think because I've been watching a lot of like Edinburgh Yarn Fest episodes of podcasts because I like to torture myself. So hers came up in the like sidebar. I was watching Katie, I think, inside number 23, maybe. And so it came up in the sidebar and I liked the name, so I clicked on it and I'm glad I did because it was a really, really nice podcast. She's lovely to listen to. And she in her Edinburgh Yarn Festival episode was showing all the yarn she picked out for a Harry Potter inspired fade, completely inspired by like the Hogwarts houses and stuff, and I loved it. It was so cute. I think it's gonna be a really pretty shawl, so I'm excited to see that get knit up. But you should definitely check her out. That's Nikki of TM Possibilities if you haven't already. She is absolutely lovely. So like I said, Luke and I went on that day trip. We went to the yarn store and then we went to a comic book store. We actually went to two comic book stores and they were really, really nice comic book stores. Like, I was kind of like, when you see them from the outside, they don't look like much, but then you go inside and they're really, really nice. We didn't get anything from either of them, unfortunately, but they had some really fun stuff. And we went to IKEA and we love IKEA. We love eating at IKEA. We love walking through IKEA. We love the marketplace at IKEA, where you buy all, like, the weird random little things. And I bought, like, washi tape and dish towels and just, like, stuff like that. It's funny because, like, usually we go with my parents. We double date with my parents all the time. And, like, is that weird that, like, we love double dating with my parents? Because, like, we do. We really do. Which, oh my gosh, totally forgot. Reminds me that I gave my dad his socks and he really, really liked them. He absolutely loved them. And he was so excited and they fit him perfectly. And I was, like, worried that the heel was not going to fit right because you just never know. And, like, he said it fit better than a store-bought heel. So that was, like, yay! So definitely someone that I can be knitting socks for gifts. And can I just say, like, my dad is one of the most knit-worthy people that I've ever met. Because I made him a hat for Christmas this year. And, like, every chance he gets, he tells me, like, oh, I wear your hat all the time. I wear the hat that you made me all the time. And so, like, that was just kind of funny. But this time we didn't go with my parents, and it was a little weird because we usually are with them. That same weekend, it was actually the day before. I'm not going in order because that's for normal people. We celebrated my brother's 32nd birthday. And that was nice. Good cake, good food. And then after they went home, my mom and Luke watched, like, what's that show? Cutthroat Kitchen. I don't like that show very much. It stresses me out, and I just don't get it, and everybody's annoying. So while they were watching that, my dad and I went downstairs and, like, had a little jam sesh. And by jam sesh, I mean, like, mostly it's just me, like, picking out, like, songs on YouTube. Be like, can you play this? And then he'll, like, learn it on the spot. Because my dad is not like me in the sense that he can just listen to something and pick it up, and he can, like, play it immediately with all the nuances, like, all the little, like, embellishments. He can just pick that up in, like, 15 minutes. I don't know how he does it. I need to have a tab if I'm gonna learn something on the guitar. It's nuts. But one of the things that we always play together is Like a Rolling Stone by Bob Dylan, because we like to sing like Bob Dylan. We went to a Bob Dylan concert. It was awesome. It was a total train wreck, and it was perfect. Gosh, I'm sorry if you can hear, like, I have a sore throat today, and I feel like it's starting to come through a bit as I talk. But can I just say, I play a mean harmonica for Like a Rolling Stone. I've got that thing down pat. So it was, like, almost 11 o'clock at night, and my dad is playing guitar, we're both singing, I'm wailing on a harmonica, I'm really sorry to my parents' neighbors, but, like, we couldn't help it, we just had to do it, and it was a lot of fun, and, like, it's something, like, I used to do with my dad all the time. It's just, like, listen to him play and, like, sing along, and, I mean, like, since I was little, and there's always kind of been, like, a rotation of songs that are sort of our obsession. But I had actually thought about, like, Rolling Stone as our song, like, our father-daughter dance at my wedding, because it's kind of like, it was just a joke, but I didn't make everybody in that reception hall sit through 6 minutes of, like, Rolling Stone, don't worry. I've been working, it's been okay. It's just kind of like, I was gonna say something, what was it? Oh, no, it was kind of cool because I have a history background, and I'm directing Beauty and the Beast, and it's just one of those things where, like, I really want the kids to understand the context of what they're doing and understand the history of it and understand the clothing and whatever, because even though, like, their costumes may not directly reflect the period, you know, they need to act like it is. So we had a really fun time discussing the history of Beauty and the Beast and the history of 18th century France. And can I just say, like, it makes me really, really happy when I see kids getting excited about history. Because the world tells us that history is boring. It's always, like, everybody's least favorite subject in TV and movies. I don't know why. The history teacher is always some droning old person like Professor Binns in Harry Potter. And I'm like, that's not true. Like, I maybe had one professor like that in history, or one teacher like that in history. Every other history teacher I've ever had has been so excited and so passionate about the subject. I mean, that's why they devoted their life to it. And so that's why, one of the reasons I love it. And I don't, like, maybe I'm weird, but whenever I watched Disney movies as a kid, is like, it would inspire me to go and look up that time. Or, you know, like, whatever. Like, even, like, when I watched Pocahontas, which I'm not gonna get into that, but, like, it inspired me then to go and research, like, Native American history and actually get real facts about it. Like, do you know what I mean? And I want kids to feel that way because I want them to get excited about the past as well as the future. And I want them to know the difference between the past and the present when they're, you know, trying to develop characters. But it was just really special for me to see a group of kids, you know, ages like 10 to 15, getting truly excited about it and like hands flying up and questions being asked. And, you know, they all wanted to know about what their characters would have been like, what their life would have been like. And, you know, even, you know, they're just playing the egg seller or the hat seller or whatever. And I just think that's so good. Am I, like, weird for saying that? Like, is that weird? Am I in the minority? I don't know. Like, I've always been kind of obsessed with tradition, I guess. Like, even the knitting. Like, one of the things I love about it is being part of a tradition, so. Anyway, I'm gonna stop waxing poetic about history now because you guys are probably going, that's enough, Joy. But anyway, I think that I'm gonna call it a day. My throat is hurting really bad right now, and I have a meeting to go to later. I have a training session for my preschool literacy job, which I'm not really looking forward to, but it's mandatory, so gotta do it, and hopefully it's not too long. It's supposed to be 2.5 hours, but hopefully, cross your fingers for me, guys, that it won't be the full 2.5 hours and it'll end early. Yes, so thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you liked this setup better. I actually do kind of like it. I like the light better. If you would like to find me elsewhere on the internet, you can find me on Ravelry as Dabblejoy. And if you would like to find me on Instagram, where I'm the most active, you can find me as RhinelandStory. And as always, that information will be in the description box below. I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your week, a wonderful weekend. Happy knitting, happy living, over and out.